Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Prema Bhatt. I'm a classical music vocalist from South India. I'm going to say a few things about how storytelling is done in Indian classical music, and we'll also sing some songs. Storytelling through music had been practiced in India for thousands of years. The great Hindu epics Ramayana and Mahabharata are in the form of very long poetry. The classical composers in South India were also saint singers, and they were great spiritual teachers and philosophers. And in their songs, some of their songs, here and there they cite some instances and stories from mythology, and many times connecting the past with the present through these stories. The very first song is on Ganesha. Ganesha is the elephant-faced god. He is also believed to be the remover of obstacles. So in India, we pray at the beginning of any event for an auspicious beginning, for we believe that he removes the obstacles that might happen. And in this song, Purandara Dasa, one of the great composers from the 15th century, says why we pray to Ganesha in the beginning of the event, and he explains a small story of Ravana, the demon king, who did not pray to Ganesha one time. And he narrates the story. Many times the songs, the stories in the songs are very short. They are not explained fully, but within few words or maybe a sentence or two. And here, Purandara Dasa says how Ravana, the demon king, once he started to meditate on Hindu god Shiva because he wanted to get a boon, wanted to get a favor from Shiva, but he forgot to pray to Ganesha. Shiva is pleased with him and he appears before him and asks, whatever you want to ask, go ahead and ask. And Ravana says, okay, give me the boon where nobody, I shall not be killed by anybody, from any gods, no animals, no other creatures, but he forgot to say human beings. And Shiva says, as you say, and he gives a symbol of him and asks Ravana to take this to Lanka, his palace, and worship there. But he lays a condition. Never put it down. Don't put it down under any circumstance. So it's a heavy rock he has to carry all the way to Lanka. So Ravana carries it, and on the way he has to answer the call of the nature. In the meantime, the lesser gods, they are worried that Ravana might become very powerful because of this boon. They pray to Ganesha. They appeal to Ganesha and says, somehow you have to help. And here comes Ganesha. When Ravana is looking for somebody to carry the statue, because he's ordered not to put it down. And Ravana is looking for somebody, and there appears Ganesha as an ordinary boy. And Ravana says, can you help me? So Ganesha offers to help him with a condition. I'll count only three. One, two, three, and you have to be back. And I cannot stay longer than that. And as soon as Ravana leaves, he starts to count one, two, three, and he puts the statue down and he leaves. And when Ravana comes back, the statue is rooted deeply into the ground and he could not remove it under any circumstance. And Ravana had to go back to Lanka without the statue and without any protection from the bone. And Purandara Dasa, the composer, says, so today we all pray to Ganesha and we know that he always removes the obstacles that might happen. So here is the song.
Chindadin ಬಲಿ ಸಕಲ ಸಿದ್ಧಿಗಳಿತ್ತು ಇಂದು ಜಗವೆಲ್ಲ ಒಮ್ಮೆಯೆ ನಂದನನ ಪೂಜಿಸಲು ಚಂದದಿಂದಲೇ ಸಕಲ ಸಿದ್ಧಿಗಳಿತ್ತು ತಂದೆ ಸಿರಿಪುರಂ
comes from the 17th century composer Tyagaraja. In this song, this story also comes from the mythology Ramayana. The story focuses on the unconditional love and devotion of a devotee called Shabari, whose only desire, she was an elderly lady and her only desire was to see the Prince Rama, the main character from Ramayana, and for years and years living in the forest, every day she collects fresh fruits, every day she spreads flowers on the way for him to walk. So this keeps on going for many years, and one day actually Rama comes along with his brother Lakshmana looking for his wife Sita, and he enters the ashram of Shabari. Shabari is overjoyed, and she had been waiting for this for many years, and she offers him the best fruits that she had collected that day. She had spread flowers on the path, and she bites every fruit that she was going to offer to Ram, which we never do that in any tradition. We never eat the fruit and give, but she wanted to make sure that he only ate the sweetest of fruits. So Rama eats these fruits so happily, and she had never asked for a boon. She did not ask for any boon. She did not ask for any favor. She did not want to ask for anything. This is all she wanted to do. She wanted to serve him once. And Rama, seeing her innocence and unconditional love and devotion, he grants her salvation, the freedom from birth and death, and she leaves her earthly body right there. With a glow, she goes to heaven. And here is the song.
ಎಂತ ನಿಮ್ಮ
15th century composer Purandaradasa. Here he offers his salutations to Hanuman, the monkey-faced god. And this story is also taken from the Hindu epic Ramayana. The story goes like this. Prince Rama is looking for his wife Sita, who has been kidnapped by the demon king Ravana when Rama was away. Rama, along with his brother Lakshmana, looks for Sita everywhere and in the forest and asks everybody, whoever they could find, if they had seen Sita. And there in the forest, they find Hanuman. And Rama asks Hanuman if he could help to find Sita. Hanuman is immediately taken by this prince, his love for Sita, and how sad he feels without her, and he really wants to help her. And in this song, Purandaradasa gives three instances from that story as how he looks for Sita to help Rama. He says how he crosses the ocean, a little monkey crossing the ocean, flying in the sky, looking for Sita for many days, and how he finds the city of Lanka, where he finds Sita, and how he gives the ring to Sita that was given by Rama to be given to Sita, and how Hanuman sets fire to the city of Lanka. And here is that song.
last song. Is composed by the same singer Meera. She comes from the 15th century and she was a Rajasthani princess and also a devotee of Krishna, the Hindu god. Her songs are called bhajans or sacred songs and they are sung throughout India. Here she describes her hero, Krishna, as the remover of sorrow and suffering. And she cites the example of Draupadi, the wife of Pandava princess, who was brought in front of the court by the Kauravas to be humiliated. And while she is crying for help and everybody is watching her helplessly, it was Krishna with one call. He increased the length of her sari so that she is not humiliated in front of everybody. In another instance, she cites the example of very different time period of another story, how he takes the form of half lion and half human to protect one of his devotees, Prahlada. He did not waste any time there. And in another story of the Elephant King, how the Elephant King calls for help when he was dragged into the water by a crocodile and how he pulls him out of the water. And here is that song.
Thank you. I hope you have a good time.